they are taking their bow as usual because they were assumed to have been supreme earlier or before.
They just took a bow. Martin said there was no need screening because they've been screened before.
And this is where we are in Rivers State, and the opposition parties are saying, look, these guys should stop insulting our sensibility because all these cases are in court. And whatever is before the court of judicial proposition, I mean, you should just stop, So for you, what would you make of this whole thing? Because they sit, and as a matter of fact, they even said that they have told the governor to ask his people not to reject correspondences from them, or else they will also stop receiving any correspondence from the government house. And so the story is just getting interesting. And for me, as a person, they have been screened. How many hours now? About 48 hours now to be screened. They are yet to be sworn in. And I don't understand because before, when they are screened early in the morning, in the evening they could be sworn in, or at most the next day, 24 hours after they are screening. But this is 48 hours after screening and they are yet to be sworn in. So what do you think is happening?
Well, in the first place, thank you for inviting me to this place to discuss this matter. It's very, very serious matters and concerns me because as a stakeholder in Rivers politics, it is very important I throw my word on it. In the first place, it's a display of lack of integrity. I used to understand that when a man tenders a resignation from where he works, he or she works, and if for any reason there is a negotiation anywhere, you reapply for such position to be retained. But in this place, you see a man who refused to work on integrity. If you were in Port Harcourt some weeks back when this resignation was like letters everywhere, you see this one said, I'm resigning because of integrity, called my conscience. I'm resigning because of my belief. Now, if all these beliefs are no more on ground, because it demands that, you still let people, the way you display yourself, your integrity, you display yourself everywhere, you should come back again to the people and said, oh, I have understood myself now and my integrity has now reversed back. My conscience is now backward or forward. For me, I don't talk about the issues of assembly because these are people that we believe are lawmakers who knows the law. You get House of Assembly. And the man also received the budget and has passed the budget. When the crisis became so much that the governor needed peace, and he respectfully resigned his appointment, and also resigned his membership of the assembly. And before he resigned, of course you know that he doesn't have a deputy. So invariably, what it means is that River State, as at today, has no existing River State House of Assembly because it has no leadership. The people that should be talking about River State's legislation should be talking about the National Assembly, who are the rightful people to decide on what happened in River State now. I don't know why the National Assembly is here to take over that.
But National now, Assembly, have they been informed? Because they need to be informed.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying by the legal means,
okay,
by rights, by law. You get? By legal means, the National Assembly is supposed to take over the leadership of the River State House of Assembly because right now the House of Assembly is in chaos.
Okay, here is an interesting
now,
part.
Let me go back
this.
To the quick question. The question, okay. I use this as a joiner.
Okay.
The main question is the commissioner. I think.
Commissioners, nine commissioners.
Yes, nine commissioners.
Former commissioners.
No,
they have been restrained.
For me, in as much as there is no legal River State House of Assembly, nothing has happened in River State.
Okay. Let me come in this way. We had a lawyer on our first show today. Part of this issue came up and he said, which was the threat by Martin Amewule, that if the River State government failed to submit the 2024 appropriation bill again to them, that they will stop receiving correspondence from the government. Now, I asked, the River's elders have also gone to court suing President Tinubu, the governor of Rivers State, and several others. Martin is also on that list of defendants, saying that they should not, that the governor must not submit, to, that the court should stop the governor from submitting the budget to the assembly again. Now, in the face of all of this, he said, the lawyer said, that so long as the matter is already in court, nobody should be doing anything about it. Now, I'm bringing this to ask, Martin Amaewhule is supposed to be, is a lawmaker. I don't know if he's a lawyer by profession, but he's a lawmaker. Speaker of the River State House of Assembly, quote and unquote.
Former.
Okay. So now, if you put that side by side and ask yourself, they have gone to courts asking the court to authenticate them as lawmakers. Mm. See me, stop looking at me. To authenticate them still as lawmakers.
I need to understand where you're going to. That's how
So they've gone to courts at 15th of December asking the court to authenticate them as lawmakers based on PDP saying that they INEC should declare their seat vacant and Edison declared their seat vacant. But the worry we have now in this particular instance, if you have gone to court, like the lawyer mentioned in the morning, said your matter is in court, why are you acting under before the court gives a position on whether you're a lawmaker or not? That's number one. Why are the commissioners, you understand, why are you now threatening that the governor must accept what you have done? Because the governor is saying that he will not do anything that is contrary to the law or that is not in the interest of Rivers people. These nine people resigned to say that they have integrity to protect and all of that. You were called to serve Rivers people, you abandoned that. Why is it that a lawmaker who should know the law is consciously going against the law and threatening the executive governor of Rivers State?
You are telling me what the governor didn't say. My governor did not make any comment on these issues.
No, I didn't say the governor. I said the lawmaker is Martin Amaewhule.
He said, so
he knows the law.
Yes.
He's in position to direct
the
law.
Now, let me help you.
Okay.
Let me help you out so I don't flog the issues. In quote, integrity and lack of integrity.
For the commission, former commissioners.
Yes. Now, for Amaewhule, like you said, Amaewhule still believe in the, in quote, tyrannical life and leadership that has existed in Rivers State over 8 years ago. Unfortunate to them, God handed Rivers State peace by returning peace through Governor Sim Fubara. Incidentally, what is happening in Rivers State today? Should it be any of them that are the governor of, that is the governor of Rivers State today? I'm telling you, most of us cannot even stay here today. So we thank God for giving us Sim, who is a man that thinks before action. You know, when a man does not think before action, he is himself by his own bullets. Their reactions now is as a result of acting before thinking. If they are taught wisely, they will not take their actions in the first place. So coming back, they are trying to fuse themselves into government by all costs, which is not, there's no place for that. And I thank God. The governor, in the first place, he said, I will respond to those issues by rule of law. He paid them their salaries, their allowances and salaries. And to tell you that the governor is smarter than all of them, they're crying. The governor inserted Amaewhule's name on the program, even against the wish of Rivers people, on the program for banquets, and invited the so-called 27 assembly members. They boycotted it. Madam, for instance, if you are married to this man here and you have issue with this man, and I and some one of you invited me into this matter and I settled you people, will I be there in the house to continue settlement?
No.
Either you go back to your husband and say, I'm sorry for it. And your husband says, okay, don't worry, there's soup in the pot to go and make sure there's brief food to eat. But this you want to avoid. How do you have peace in the house? They lacked genuine reconciliative measure in them, and they are not ready for peace in River State that the governor is trying to sustain to bring back River State. If actually they are ready for peace, the governor's door, I know, is open.